I first heard about it through my agent, as always. But the main thing was Greta Gerwig and Margot, two of my icons and women I look up to very, very much. So it was very exciting. And I sent in a few tapes and pestered my agent every single day, being like, are you sure they got them? Do they like them? Can I do them again? I'll do them a million more times if I have to. I can do accents. I can do everything. And I was just so thrilled that it even came onto our desk. So I was very excited about it. And yeah, Ryan is exquisite. He is so, I don't know why I said that word like an old lady. He's exquisite. Ryan is so special also because he's very, very generous, but he has brought this little boy energy to Ken, which is so perfect. This thing of trying to make someone else proud or to try and like, pretend you're strong and confident and know exactly what you're doing. And he has all of these idiosyncrasies and these little expressions that he has that are so childish, but so perfect for Ken, because Ken is kind of an unevolved man. He's like an unevolved human. He hasn't quite got there yet, which is a really, so it's great. So he's obviously tapped into that childlike humor and the I don't know, I just think it's very smart how he's done it. And we can see a real progression as well, obviously, because he goes on a whole epic journey as well alongside Barbie. It's great to have the solid, precise script that you have in the beginning as a foundation, and then you can, you know, draw it out and spin all these different kinds of webs. So when she saw that, obviously, Ncuti and I are dear friends and we've worked together before, and I think she just saw that we had a connection and that we adore each other. And naturally, I think over the first couple of weeks, she started having the idea, or the seed was planted, that maybe there could be something more. And then she was like, I think you guys should be each other's Barbie and Ken. I think you guys are in love, platonically, but I think you're in love. And I was like, yeah, okay. And me and she were like, this is the best thing ever. I'm so sorry, but you're stuck with me again. But it was just really special because it's so lovely to be seen and to know that someone is seeing you for who you are and knows that you can bring something different and that you have this potential that needs to be used, not for me, but for, you know, for anyone, all of us. I think that's what's been so great, is that when I speak about progression and confidence and precision, is that Greta has been able to pluck things out of all of us that have made sense for our Barbies, but also for us, and have made, and I don't think she knows this, I don't think she knows she's doing this, I don't think she does it conscientiously, but she just, it's just part of her plethora of skills. That was the first thing we shot, pretty much. So that was very early on in the shoot. And it's always fun, not that I've done it very much, but it's always fun learning a skill or practicing for something before you go on a film. It makes you feel like a real actor. And it was just, it was great to have a couple of weeks of rehearsals with the Barbies beforehand and getting to meet the dancers and being in the studio space and then practicing here the day before we started shooting. So again, a real progression and a short space of time to do it in, but I think it looks so good. And the dancers were incredible and were on their feet from like 5 a.m. till 8 p.m. every day for 4 days straight. It was pretty amazing. I mean, the costumes are incredible. It was the first time that I felt involved in the process, because Greta kind of gave us the green light to ensure that we felt comfortable and beautiful and whatever that means for us. And I think it's a really good way to go about it, because you're not being imposed something. And weirdly, even though we are playing dolls and it should be costume-esque, it actually feels, they feel like clothes, which is great. And that's the whole point. That's how a costume should feel. It should feel like you could just pop this on every day. So it feels right in the setting. Jacqueline and her team were inspired by Slim Aaron's photography. So there was a very specific starting point. And then, because we go through the decades together, all of us, it's a costume designer's dream to be able to go through all of those different decades and get to do it with dolls. I mean, it's pretty special. So I think they had a great time doing it. I think it's a lot of work. And I'm, again, in awe of what they've done. I think it's pretty momentous. It's never been seen before, you know? And I think to be able to do that today, where everything is recycled, and it's not bad. It's fine to recycle films and references, of course, and we do that in this film. But I think to be able to write a film and to write characters that have never been done before is so great and so special. And I tend to watch films once, and I feel like Barbie will be one of those films that people watch again and again, because there's so much in it and there's so much to unpack and there are so many references. And then depending on whether you see it when you're 15, and you'll watch it when you're 13, like, oh, I didn't get that reference because I hadn't watched that. And it will just keep reinventing itself. I really think that, and I think that's the secret to a great piece of art, is its timelessness. So yes, that's what I think.